I'm going to be showing you how to get all 10 minikits in the hidden enemy level in LEGO Star Wars 3, The Clone Wars. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so for minikit number 1, we're going to have to destroy 10 of these like purple desks, I guess is what we'll call them. So there is the first one there in the starting room. Then we're going to switch to a small character and go through the small character hatch. There's going to be 2 more of those desks in here. You just have to use the Force on them first with a Jedi or Sith, and then you can just kind of destroy them. So now we have 3 out of 10. So now we're going to switch gears to minikit number 2 in this room. Just use the Force to connect the power to that third outlet. And then you can grab minikit number 2 right there. So now we're going to use the small character hatch to go back towards the normal story progression of the level. And we're going back to minikit number 1 here to get a couple more of those purple desks. So after you break the glass here on the left side is going to be the next one. Use the Force and destroy it. So that is 4 out of 10. And now we're going to clear out the enemies here and make our way to the next room because that's going to be where the next desk is. And there it is, sort of towards the camera there. Use the Force and do a ground pound to destroy it. So that is 5 out of 10. So moving on to minikit number 3 here, over here on the left side, if you just switch to a hovering character like Cad Bane or R2-D2, you can hover over here to minikit number 3. Alright, so as you progress the level, you'll eventually reach this area. And from here, we're going to head down towards the camera and use this bounty hunter panel with Cad Bane, any bounty hunter character like that. And this little probe droid is going to bring up minikit number 4 for us there. So minikit number 5 is also going to be here. We're going to switch to a dark side Sith character like Count Dooku. And there's going to be 4 of these little wheels that we need to turn around this room. So there is 2 of 4, and it's just in each of the 4 corners of the area. And there is 3 of 4, and then last but not least over here on the left is going to be 4 of 4. And then on top of there is minikit number 5. So for minikit number 6, we're going to switch to a sniper character like Aurora Singh. And we're going to have to snipe 3 different spider droids, I think is what they're called, in the background. They're highlighted green, so they're not too hard to miss. But they are way back in the background, and once you destroy all 3 of them, you'll be able to get minikit number 6. So that's it for this area. We're now going to go back to minikit number 1 with those purple desks. And the next area of the level, there's going to be a purple desk right here. So use the Force on it and destroy it. And that is 6 out of 10. So from there, we're going to head over here to the right side and switch to a protocol droid like C-3PO to hack open this little panel. Inside here is going to be our next purple desk. So we're going to go ahead and destroy that one. And that is going to be 7 out of 10. So now we're going to switch over to minikit number 7. If you choose a Force character and attach this little power line to the middle port there, we can then jump up and destroy whatever's on top of that desk and grab minikit number 7. Alright, so for minikit number 1 now, after you do the boss fight with Ventress, there's going to be a couple more of those purple desks in this room in the back left and right corners of the room. So that brings us up to 9 out of 10. And then we're going to progress into the next room, and I'm going to skip ahead after we fight Ventress just to get her out of the way. And over here in the back left corner of this room is going to be the final desk, and that is 10 out of 10, giving us minikit number 1. Alright, so back up to minikit number 8 in this same room. We're going to switch to a dark side character like Count Dooku to use the Force on 4 different books. There's going to be 2 on each side. Just kind of put them on the little purple bookshelf there. Once you do that, you can grab minikit number 8. So for minikit number 9, we're going to progress the level as we normally would against Ventress. But before you go out there and fight her some more, you're going to switch to a dark side character and use the Force on both the left and right side of this little room here. It's going to reveal 2 different cars, and what we have to do is drive those back to the library room that we were just in, and you just have to drive the cars on top of these 2 different platforms, and that's going to unlock the next minikit for us. So make sure you don't progress the level any further, because once you get outside there, it's going to block and you have to replay the whole level to get this. So once we park both of those 2 cars there, we'll have this nice little Indiana Jones 3 Easter egg there for us. And after Indy disappears, we'll be able to grab minikit number 9. So minikit number 10, this is in the final area as we're falling on this spider droid. There's going to be 10 super battle droids that we need to destroy. And so this is fairly simple. Just make sure you don't progress the boss fight with Ventress until you destroy 10 different super battle droids that keeps infinitely respawning. So, you know, as long as you don't progress the level, you can definitely do this. There's 8 out of 10, 9 out of 10, and 10 out of 10, and boom, that is all 10 minikits in the hidden enemy level in LEGO Star Wars 3 The Clone Wars. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions. Like this video if you enjoyed it. Dislike if not. Subscribe for more content like this, and I'll see you guys next time here on Quick Break Games.